Hello friend, welcome back. In this video, I will discuss about the blade templates, how the blade template actually work. I will show you that things with a live example. Like in our previous video here, I just showing some of the name as Ariyan, as a first name, and the last name as a Kazi. And here I just defining that things with using the plain PHP code. Like if you go to the about page, like there is our about page, and here you can see I just using the plain PHP code. PHP echo, and here I just define the variable for the first name and the last name. In Laravel, if you want to echo this variable, then you can use the one of the syntax on particular dispositions. Like here, I just show you. So I just want to convert from the plain PHP code to blade template engine syntax. So how can actually add that syntax? I will show you. For doing this Laravel syntax, then you have to define the second bracket, double second bracket. Okay. And into the double second bracket, simply you have to add this variable. So here I just define that variable on particular disposition. And then you don't need to do anything. So here I just remove it. And also I remove our plain PHP and code. And now there is a clear first name. Okay, so now I just want to do the same things for our last name. So here I just want to copy it, and here I just assign it. So for now our variable is the last name. So here I just define the last name and I just remove all the things from here. So it's pretty much the same things. Like here, if you click on the save all, and if you now refresh that page, then you will get the same result. So that is actually the one of the Laravel syntax. So here we have to actually use it. So here I just want to use that syntax on particular disposition. I hope you can well understand about it. And in this video, I will show you about the another things. Like if you want to segment your page, like if you want to segment your page with the header part, if you want to segment with the footer part, the sidebar part, and the main content area. Because every dynamic website, they have some of the segment. Okay, so then actually it should be better, and it makes your site so much interactive. So how can do that things in the blade? I will show you. Then it should be very much clear to you. For doing this, like in our view page, okay, like here, I just want to create another page. So for now, I just click on the save as, and here I just name it as a master. Okay, master.blade.php, and I just save it. And into the master blade, here I just define all of the HTML. Okay, here I just define all the HTML, and here I just define in the online news. And into the body part, here I just want to add some of the segment, because as I told you, I also want to segment our page. So how can do that work? I will show you. Like here, first of all, I just define the one of the section. So here I just added that things with the at the rate and then section. Okay, and into this part here, I just define one of the section as a sidebar. Okay, I just define that things as a sidebar. And now also you have to and that sidebar. So here you have to define that as a and section. Okay, and section, but right now I just want to show that page for the every pages. For the reasons here, I just defining another things like as a show. So here I just define the show. Okay, and also I just define the another part for this one, like here, for the reasons I just define on the div on particular disposition. And into the div area, I just define another one like as a yield. Okay, yield, and yield is the another things, like if you want to make your one of the part, like if you want to make one of the dynamic part of your site, okay, so then this will be actually onto the yield part option area. For now here I just defining the yield, and here I just defining one of the component. Okay, here I just defining as a component on particular disposition. And in our sidebar here, I just put some of the text, like here I just defining the para. Okay, like I just defining the para, and here I just defining as a this is parent or master page. Okay, and I just close that p. For now in our about page here, okay, for now I just remove all the things from here. And first of all here I just define the extend which part. So into the position I just want to extend, that means I just want to include that in our master, that means this page. So here I just defining that master. Okay, I just defining the master, and then I also want to add that section. That means they have done the sidebar section. So I just defining the sidebar section on particular disposition. For doing this, you have to write as a section, and into this position, I just want to visible our sidebar. So here I just defining the sidebar, and now also I have to and that section. So here I just defining the and section. Okay, so here I just defining the and section, and also here you can see I just make the things as a show, and here I just defining one of the text. Okay, so for now I just make the things as a parents. So here I defining on particular dispositions, because I also want to display that name. So here I just put the things as a parent. Okay, I just define that as a parent on particular disposition. And now here I also want to assign some of the text on particular dispositions, like here I just defining one of the para, and here I just defining as a this about sidebar. Okay, so here I just defining and like this about sidebar, and into dispositions I have another one, like that is a yield for the component. So I also want to add some of the section for this one. So here after this, okay, after this I just want to create another section. I just defining another section into this position. I just defining the name as a component. So here that is a component, so I just copy it and I just define that component on particular this area. And also I want to and that section. Okay, so here I just defining the and section. And into this position I want to add some of the headline, like I will show you when I actually brand that page, then you'll well understand about it. Like I just defining as a about our space. Okay, here I just defining as a about our space. So for now, if you click on the save all, and now if you click on the this page, that means our about page. So if you now refresh that page, now you can see that is actually showing as a this is parent and master class. So that is one of the part, that is another part, and that is also the another part. So all the things I combining with the section, I hope you can well understand about it. Like that is our about us page. That means I actually run that page. And here, first of all, I extend our master page. So that means this master page. So all the things will be included. Okay. For the reasons, you can see there is also updated the title. That is online news. So in our master page here, I just defining one of the title as a online news. And for the reasons, it's now showing as a title. And also here I just defining one of the paragraph as a this is parent or the master page. And here if you go to these positions, like in our sidebar section, here I just defining that area. So in our sidebar here, I just defining that sidebar on particular disposition with this section as a sidebar. For the reasons, first of all, he just display that name. And after the sidebar here, I also defining one of the page name. So one of the link as a this about sidebar. So for the reasons it's now showing as a this about sidebar. And also there is another part. Another part is this component. So that is actually I defining as a yield component. And for the reasons I just defining the component, and here I just defining one of the text H1 tag that is actually about a space. And now it's perfectly visible on here. So I hope you can well understand about it. And another things, like if you want to add one of the PHP block, so in Blade you can also use the PHP block. So how can do that work? Like I will show you. Like in our plain PHP, or you always use the PHP block like that way, right? So that is actually our plain PHP, one of the code. But in Blade you have to write down as a @PHP. Okay, for now I just take one of the variable like as a name. And here I just define the variable name as Ariyan. Okay, I just defining my name as Ariyan, and here I just echo that our this variable name. So here I just define that name. Okay, I just define that name, and then you have to and this PHP. So @ and PHP. Okay, so that is actually the syntax you can use in Blade. So if you click on the save all, and now if you refresh that page, now you can see it's now showing the echo as Ariyan. So I hope you can well understand about it, how the Blade actually works. So for now, that is actually all the basic things. So laterally, I will actually add some of the template, and I will segment that template with the header part, sidebar part, main component part and the footer part. How can do that things with this way? How I can do that with the section way? Okay, and how can use the yield? And yield, as I told you, if you want to make one of the particular position in your website and you want to make the things dynamic, then you can use the yield. So I will show you all the things step by step with live example, because step by step we will create one of the complete online news portals. So that should be very much interactive, and after end of this course you will be able to create one of the complete project. And also when you done one of the complete project, then you will get familiar with a lot of the things. Okay, so step by step I will show you, and I hope you will enjoy it so much. So in our next video I will start a new session. It's about how you can set up your front view for project template. So thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.